Welcome back to the YouTube channel of Transition Career Solutions. As you all can see, today we will discuss ICSE History and Civics Suggestion 2019, which we call SCG Paper 1 also. It is also divided into two sections, Part 1 as well as Part 2. In Part 1, 30 marks paper is there. All question is compulsory. Question number 1 contains 10 questions in it, which is A to J, which belongs from the part of civics. Total marks is 10. Question number 2, which is also 10 question consist, which belongs from history and contemporary world. It is also 10 question, but multiply by 2, it's each question contain 2 marks, which comes into 20. So this part will be 30 marks, okay? Now come to the part 2. Which is 50 marks paper. It is divided into two sections. You can see section 1, which is civics part. Section B, it's history and contemporary world. It is written attempt 2 questions out of 3. You will get 3 questions in civics. Okay? You have to attempt 2. Each question is 10 marks in a format of 3-3 plus. And in section B, attempt 3 questions out of 5. Each question contains 10 marks in a format of 3 plus 4. 3 questions from history and 3 questions from the contemporary world. So you can see, if you wanted to go for all 3 questions of history, you can leave contemporary world here, or you can choose between the contemporary world and history. Okay, student? Always remember, in history you can't say which is important and which is not important. History is a vast label, but usually all chapter comes in a history question paper. You have to look after that which questions are very common in last 5 years and go through those part of questions, okay? Even I have suggested some questions to you. I will definitely give you now, as well as you can check out in the description box, okay? But dear, it's my humble request. Do not write any story about anything, okay? This is history. You have to go through whatever is written in a history book, because you can't change history, okay? Let's start with important question of civics. If you can see that I have already list out 20 questions of civics, these all are important. They might come in your examination this year. Look, I am not the paper setter, so I can't just give you a sure shot questions. I can just suggest you, this may come in your examination, and after my analysis and then my instinct, I can say that these questions will definitely appear in your paper this year. You can see there's a different, it is written difference in terms of office between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. If you have already done 5 years, 10 years of your history paper, you can just go through that. You must have seen that there is a lot of questions related to Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. What is the term of Rajya Sabha? Can it be dissolved? Differences in election of President and Vice President of India. This is also very important, okay? Differences between the Cabinet and Council of Ministers with the reference to their responsibility in the government. This is also very important. I am just putting a tick mark so you can go through that questions very well. And state one differences in between the district judge and the session judge. How does the High Court protect the fundamental rights of individual? Okay, so these are the questions are the most important, definitely. Three, after listing out the 5, 3 will definitely come from this side. But as I always said, I am not the paper setter. I am just suggesting you the question paper. Okay, so you can go through this question. It may come in your examination of 2019. We'll talk about now important questions of history. Okay, as you can see, I have already listed out 30 questions of history. So you must have seen that I have tick marked in some of the questions, which as per me, it's more important. Rather, other is also important, but you have to go through with these also. Okay, little bit more focus on that part. Like question number 5, mention two reasons for the failure of CRIPS mission, write two proposal also. Question number 6, when did Jallianwala Bagh tragedy happen? You must know, then write it properly, do not illustrate it more, okay? Question number 12, why did Muslim League observe a day of mourning? You have to go very nicely why. Just write it down the point of it. It will be more good if you can point out each and everything properly. As I said before, do not write your own story. History cannot be repeated, okay? Now question number 14, write four method and direction of Gandhiji. Question number 21, state two factors responsible for the growth of nationalism in India. Question number 25, name the presidents who presided over the first two sessions of the Indian National Congress. Okay. 28, what are the factors leading to the formation of Muslim League? 30th, state any two contributions of Dada Bhai Naroji, Surendranath Banerjee and Gopal Krishna Gokhale. You have to go with all these questions, student. I must say it may come in your examination of 2019, but give a little more focus, whatever I have ticked out in this. Okay, now we'll talk about important questions of contemporary world. In this also I have took out the 20 questions which are very important from my side. Okay, question number 3, I have already ticked it out. Discuss the function of UNESCO. Question number 7, explain three consequences of Second World War. Question number 8, name the architect of NAM, non-aligned movement. Question number 10, write the contribution of Jawaharlal Nehru, list out the 4 points. 12, when did Hitler attack Poland? 20, write the composition and functions of Security Council. So student, just go through these questions. You can download these questions from description box as well. I will put a PDF format there. It's a humble request. It's every time I'm telling you, do not write your own story. Whatever is written in the history, put that. Point out kariyega to zyada aapke liye better hoga. If you can go with point 1, this year this happened. Point 2, what was the reason for the war, or what was the reason for that aligned movement. Okay, so always remember, keep your paper clean, nice handwriting should be there. Okay, if you have any kinds of question related to these part, whatever I have just suggested you, you can just comment on the comment box, or do not forget to check the description box. All the very best for your history and civics exam.